Good morning and welcome to another video. Today I'm back with another reading log. So since I finished Blade of the Immortal last night, I can read something new, and normally I would draw out of my TBR chart to see what of my big ass pile over here I'm gonna read, but JT has been raving about the Promised Neverland and how good it is right now at around volume 8, 9, 10, and I've only read up to 7, so I feel like I want to read this now before I read something else, because I want to know what the fuck happened. So I'm gonna read this first and then I'm gonna draw out of my TBR jar, so good luck to me. What a dope ass cover this is though. Like, I love it. This is so cool. I had to actually check the last few pages of volume 7 to see where it left off, but because I'm terrible and I forget. Which is good because cliffhangers. But I'm excited now, so. Just came back from meeting with my friends and doing some Japanese stuff, and I just wanted to update you real quick on my reading. This morning I, as you know, started Promised Neverland volume 8, and I also finished it, and boy, this is like Hunger Games, and wow, I can't wait to actually pick up volume 9 tomorrow morning when I get up and get ready for work. I need to read volume 9 ASAP. And I ordered volume 10, and when it arrives here, I'm going to read that one right away as well. But yeah, this is so good, and I'm crying on the inside, like, boy. Boy. Also, strong female lead character. She's awesome. So, I want to say so much about this, but I don't want to spoil anything. Like, let me know if you want me to, like, actually properly talk about everything I read, even if it's spoilers, and I am just saying beforehand that I'm gonna spoil this whatever book I'm reading at that moment, and then you can mute or skip that part in the video, or if you wanna just keep it non-spoilery, because I can talk about it like spoilery. But, you know, let me know what you think about this. Spoilers in my vlogs or not? I mean, obviously, as I said, I would say when I spoil. So you can still mute or skip so you won't be spoiled. But if you've read it and you want to know what I think, let me know if you want me to actually properly talk about the things I read and even spoil it. So yes, question to you guys. Spoilers in my vlogs or no? Leave me a comment down below and let me know, please. Right, so I'm gonna go crash because I'm tired. And tomorrow I'm gonna read volume 9 and I'm scared, honestly. But yeah. The sun is in my face and my hair is a mess. The combination is... I'm going to the hairdresser today, so that's good. But I actually, yesterday I decided that this is going to be the last time I'm going to the hairdresser. I'm going to let it grow out again. So I'm probably going to have terrible hair for the next like 6 months, because when it's like this length, it's going to be ridiculous. But you know. Also, I'm going to start this one now. Lord help me. Can't even see because it's too bright. Hello, sun. I'm so glad you're here. So, I just watched the first two episodes of the Bleach anime, and I mean, I've never read the manga, ever, like I had no clue what this was about, except that I've watched the live action movie adaptation on Netflix, so that was the only kind of thing that I watched to know what the story is about, so I know roughly what's going on, so, but just funny to watch it, and it feels so old school. It reminds me of my old days watching anime because of like the screen. It wasn't widescreen, it was like half of it was cut off, and it's just hilarious because it reminds me of my old anime days back in the days. And I was checking when this was coming out, and it was like 2004, and I was like, oh, I've it feels older, but then I realized 2004 is a billion years ago. Yeah. I can't believe it's 15 years, holy shit. But yeah, I am enjoying it, and I just love the low quality of it. It's just so old school. It's just nostalgic for some reason. I've never seen it, but it's nostalgic for just the quality. So yeah, but I'm enjoying it, so I'm gonna continue it because the first three seasons are on Netflix, so I'm just gonna go with what's on there and see. But yeah, so far I'm enjoying it, so I'm gonna continue. Well, this morning I finished reading The Promised Neverland Volume 9 and I fucking knew it! I knew it. It just wasn't possible, so I was like, no, that can't be real. And I was right, so... But man, this has turned 180 into a mix between fucking Attack on Titan and Hunger Games, and I'm just like, damn boy. But I'm loving this and I can't wait for volume 10. They actually just sent me an email today that they shipped it, so I have to wait. Damn it, why are you so good? Why am I talking to a book? Okay, but yeah. Which means I'm up to date with The Promised Neverland. So I need to get a new book. I mean, read a new book. So I'm going to draw another book off my TBR to read next. So let's see what it's going to be. It's Chambers of Secrets, which is like on the bottom of that whole pile. Fuck that shit. But because it's the illustrated version of Harry Potter, I'm also gonna draw a second book because I like to enjoy this. So I'm just gonna read like a chapter or something and then read something else because I wanna enjoy these beautiful picture books. So, aside of Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, I'm also going to read The Girl from the Other Side. I'm only reading manga. Where is the rest? Right, so to have the proof, here is Chambers of Secrets. I don't think it's gonna zoom in, but you know. And The Girl from the Other Side. So it's actually the top book and the bottom book. Yay! Right, let's see. Oh boy. What a terrible idea I had. So, next on my reading list is Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, the beautiful illustrated version. Look at this. You got like black pages and beautiful illustrations. Look at this. Amazing. I just love this so much. I've never actually read all the books. I've been saying this forever in my videos. I've only fully read the first three. So this is a reread, but I don't remember Jack. It's been a long time. So they're so beautiful. I love them so much. So yeah, I'm gonna read this, but I'm gonna take my time with this. So I'm not gonna rush through this. So you will probably see this through many of my reading vlogs, unless I'm really into this, like I was with the last one, with the first book. I wanted to go slow there as well, but then like I just went through it, flew through it because it's just so beautiful. But yeah, so that's that. And the other thing I'm gonna read, which won't take me that long because I love this so much. So it's The Girl from the Other Side, Volume 6. That's the newest volume. This story is incredible. If you're not reading The Girl from the Other Side, what the frick are you doing? It's just so unique and the art style is so unique. And just everything, I love it so. Definitely get this if you like some mystery shit and dark stuff, but not graphic. It's just more dark as in the situation they are in. So it's more mysteriously dark. So yes, I absolutely love this manga series. It's one of my favorite series of all time. So yes, these are my reads for next, or at least that one. So yay, looking forward to this. I'm excited. So yes, I will see you in my next update. Good morning, it's Wednesday and I'm actually in Zurich again. Like I was at the gay parade, pride parade. I'm just gonna check out some bookshops and manga and comic places and just places that hopefully hire someday so I can get a job. But no, I'm just gonna check out what they actually sell and if I find something, and you know, because I'm barely here in the bookshops, so need to support. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do today. Small update. As you saw, I've been to Anolf. This is basically mainly a comic shop. Comics and figures. There is some manga, but they're mostly German manga and they're very selective. But there's a lot of comics and an English comic section as well. But it's very limited and it's expensive as fuck. So. And now I'm going over here. It's a place called Czech Manga and Anime. Which one? Obviously, it's gonna be manga anime oriented. So I'm gonna check that out and see. I know they have German and English manga, so I will check out their English section. But once again, I know it's freaking expensive. But they also have anime, obviously, and figures. So let's check it out.
Bye.
So I didn't update you again on today. I just came back from work and I had a shower, so it's been a while since I've been in Zurich. After the bookshop, the last clips you saw, I went to eat some lunch and then I actually went back home because I was too tired, and the other two bookshops I wanted to check out would have been the same company as the one you saw the video clips of. And honestly, that one you saw is the biggest and the best one, and it's my favorite one because it has a huge ass English section, and I would love to work there, honestly. There are so many English customers, and it would be so cool to talk to them in English and all, but they're not hiring, so. And the other two, Czech manga, anime, and Analf comics. I mean, if I would get a job there, I would take it because it's very similar to what I did in England, but it felt so lonely. Like, the comic shop, there were like two workers there. And in the second one, in the manga one, there was just one person there. And it feels really lonely because, I mean, I remember when I was working in England, we were like three people every day for a few hours, and four on Saturdays. So we weren't a lot either, but at least we had people to talk to. That guy in the manga shop was just all alone there, and I don't know, I don't want to be that lonely. The ones in the bookshop, they were awesome because they had loads of moments where they were laughing, and there were loads of people working there because it's like four floors and it's a lot of books there, so they have people on each floor, which would be cool. But you know, but yeah, these are my favorite three shops to go. All of them have English books, so the comic shop has English comics, the manga shop has English manga, and the bookshop has English books, but they're all three times more expensive. And this is the reason I'm online shopping, because while I could get books in these shops, it's just so much cheaper. Also, why do bookshops not have hardcovers? Makes me so sad. Like, in England there was barely any hardcovers in the bookshops, and here as well there's barely any hardcovers in the bookshop, and I'm just like, I want my hardcovers. There was one I found, Sadie, which is a book I want to read, and but it was like 30 quid, and I'm just like, yeah, no. But I wanted to get Nevernight by Jay Kristoff because I really want to read this, and but they don't have hardcover, they only have the paperback, and I'm just like, I want the hardcover. I hate that. But yeah, what I have to say though, what I saw in the comic shop, the German comics have a lot of hardcovers. Like, for example, I saw I Hate Fairyland, which in English, I assume, I'm not sure, I haven't checked that, has single trades, paperbacks, and two-in-one hardcovers because I have a hardcover. But they actually had each individual volume in a hardcover, and they all looked so cool. And there were loads of other books in German that were hardcover, single issues, single trades. And I was like, man, they're so cool, they're so beautiful. But you know, I don't really read in German, I don't want the German ones unless they don't exist. I wanted to get the Breaker because I want to have volumes 2 to 5, but they don't have it anymore, which makes me a bit worried. But yeah, that was basically today. I didn't do a lot after. Just went home and then went to work and now came back.
So I'm just gonna go read some more Harry Potter because I'm really digging it. I did, while I was eating lunch, I did read one chapter of The Girl from the Other Side, but that's basically all I've read. I couldn't concentrate, it was too loud. But yeah, so I'm gonna read this tomorrow morning and I'm gonna read some Harry Potter now. So that's my plan. As you saw last night, I've been reading one more chapter of Harry Potter until it went dark outside and I had to go inside. And this morning I've read or finished The Girl from the Other Side, volume 6. And holy shit, the cliffhanger in the end got me like, whoa, hell to the no, and I want to see where this is going, and I'm curious as hell to where this is going, and I want the next volume right now. Why is there no more? Ah, this is such a slow release, but I'm loving this series so much, it's so good. So yeah, I definitely can't wait for more of this. But that means, since I'm reading Harry Potter on the side, even though I've been reading more of it than I thought I would, I need to draw a new book from my TBR jar. So let's see what I'm gonna read next. Right, so my next read is gonna be Blue Lily, Lily Blue. You can't see that. So it's another novel. Which means it could take a while. But let's do it. Right, so my next read is Blue Lily, Lily Blue by Maggie Stiefvater, which is the third book in the Raven Cycle series. And this is basically about couple boys from a all boys school, and the Raven boys, and they're all individually different, and everyone carries a secret or has like a special characteristic to them, and it's about a Welsh king that one of them is trying to find the Welsh king, and it's ley lines and it's a bit of magic involved, and characters with special abilities, and the main girl's family is our psy chicks. I never know how to say that word, but yeah, they read cards and you know, do all this witchy thing. So yes, this is gonna be the third book. I don't really know. The second book revolved around Ronan more, so I'm not sure what this one is gonna be. Also, if the main girl kisses her true love, this person is gonna die, so there's another thing happening. And there's just a lot of like magical stuff and mystery and things I can't say without spoiling. So yes, I'm excited to read book three. So yes, you will see what I think about this in this and the next vlogs. So let's start this.
Okay, but I love these little bits of illustration because look at this. This is St. Pancras train station, where they always go to 9¾. And as you remember, if you've watched my England vlogs, this is where I was, and I made videos and photos of this. And it's kind of really weird to know that you've walked along these streets. I don't remember what side, because it's a bit confusing. I think this is the main part, so the train station is on this side, but I'm not completely sure. Because I don't know how accurate this is. I would have to be there and check my photos. But it's just really cool to think that, like, you've been there walking these streets where Harry Potter takes place. So yeah, but I love this art piece, this page. So yes.
Sunday evening, it's 10:15, and I haven't updated you in days. I don't remember my last update, to be honest. I'm also sick. I've been working all weekend, and yes. So, but I've been reading, just not a lot, and I've been reading the same thing, so there's not a lot to say. First off, I've read quite some pages in Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. I took away the dust jacket, so... But yeah, it says Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. I'm on page 67, which is roughly 1/4 of the book. So yes, I'm loving this. It's so beautiful. The illustrations and everything is just so beautiful. I mean, there's pages that look like this, but then there's pages that look like this, and it's just so cool to read like this. I wish loads of books were done this way, so it would be so much easier for me to read. I don't know why, but it would be. So yeah, so that's one update. And the other update is I started reading Blue Lily Lily Blue by Maggie Stiefvater, which is the third book in the Raven Cycle Quartet Quadrilogy. I'm not that far in. I'm on page 49, so chapter 5. So it takes me a while to read this, but I'm loving this. I love the characters, I love the mystery, and I'm curious to see what happens, and yes. But I'm slowly getting through this, so there's that. So usually I try to read one or two chapters of this in the morning, and one chapter of this in the evening, so... I don't know if I want to read tonight because I'm quite tired, but I stopped in the middle of a chapter, to be honest. I don't usually do that, but I was too tired. Sometimes I'm just too tired and I can't read more, so maybe I'm gonna just finish this chapter tonight. So that is my update for reading. I haven't been reading a lot, and watching, I've watched, as you saw, I have seen about 5 episodes of Bleach, and I'm really enjoying it. I watch it in the train on Mondays now, mainly, or when I just feel like it, when I'll eat lunch or something. And yeah, it's a slow process, but I have a page where I check which ones are filler episodes, because Bleach has a shit ton of filler episodes. This is ridiculous. So I'm just gonna skip those. So it's gonna take a bit, gonna go faster for me. And I also watched Modern Family on Netflix TV show, season 8, and it's hilarious. I've been binging it while doing stuff,
And I'm on episode 15 or something, so I'm almost done with the season. But I'm enjoying it, so. But there's like, that's really all the updates I have for this week. So yeah, next week is my last week of work. It's gonna be weird and fun. I don't know, I'm excited and I'm also not, because I won't have a job. But I'm also excited to do something new. So we'll see where this is going. But first off, I'm excited to just have a few weeks off. I mean, I'm gonna try and find a job as soon as possible, but the first couple of weeks I just wanna chill and do other things, so. But yeah, we'll see what happens. But yeah, that's really all the updates I have, so I'm gonna end this vlog here. And I will start a new one tomorrow, so I will see you in my next vlog. Bye. Jesus, I'm so ill. I'm dying. Also, again, I did mention before, I forgot to say, if you want me to actually talk about the books I'm reading, like, spoilery, let me know in the comments down below if you would prefer me talking spoilers or not. I mean, obviously, I would always mention when I spoil, so you can just mute the video or something when I do, when you haven't read it, but sometimes I don't know if I just want to actually talk about what I'm reading and what I'm feeling, and yeah, I can't do that without spoiling, so... But yeah, let me know down in the comments what you think about that, so yeah. But that's really it, so I will see you in my next video. Bye!